sisters. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Before we go in the word, if your Bible, lift up your Bible in the presence of Most High God and repeat after me. Praise God. I believe, what God is. The word of God is. What God can do. The word of God can do. God's word is God's will. And God's will is God's word. Therefore, I have what Bible says I can have. I am what Bible says I am. I can do what Bible says I can do. I present my body as holy and living sacrifice. Lord Jesus has given me spirit of power, love, and sound mind. I cannot be confused. I cannot be defeated. I have the mind of Christ. Jesus has made me holy and righteous. I am dead to sin, alive to God. There is no condemnation in me because I am forgiven. I have eternal and abundant life in Christ Jesus. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Let us give biggest clap offering to the Lord. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. We are going through a series with few pauses in between. And today we're going to have a last sermon in the series of Out of the Box Miracle. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. We have learned how Jesus works out his miracles. Isn't it? Praise God. We have learned three miracles, different ways. Two were the blind man, right? The one was... That's okay. Don't worry about it. One was leper. That was last Sunday. And there was one before that. The paralytic. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Today, we're going to see the out-of-the-box miracle as well. But this miracle is not performed by Jesus. And the reason that I want to study this miracle, I want to dwell on this miracle, because physically, Jesus is not present on this earth. My Bible says he's sitting in the right hand of the Father in heavenlies. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. But you and I are the hands and feet of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. You and I are his people. We are his representative, so to say, onto this earth. Hallelujah, praise God. And I want to teach you about today when an out-of-the-box miracle is done, not by Jesus, but by his people. Amen. Praise God, so that you and I can also live a life into miraculous, into prophetic, into not in a normal life, isn't it? Hallelujah, praise God, thank you. But we'll walk in the miracles every day of our life. Hallelujah, praise God, thank you, Jesus. So to go there, let's open a book of Acts, isn't it? And chapter number 3, the book of Acts is not over. It still continues right now, isn't it? And whatever happened in Book of Acts, it still continues right now. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. If you're in doubt, we can talk about it some other time. Hallelujah. But I want to focus today on this particular miracle, which is extremely out-of-the-box miracle, which is mentioned in the Book of Acts. We all know who wrote the Book of Acts. So when a doctor writes about a miracle, it is special, isn't it? Because apparently doctors don't believe in miracles, isn't it? But this is written by a Dr. Luke, and he writes about the miracles. And not just one, he writes about quite a few miracles, as Sonu mentioned. Science cannot explain sort of miracles, isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. In Book of Acts, this particular incident happens in the temple. Okay, let me tell you one amazing thing. Amazing thing. If you make an observation, if you study the life of Lord Jesus Christ, Jesus performed 39 miracles. Isn't it? Mentioned by all four different gospels, and they are all not same in all different gospels. Some mentions more, some mentions less. Out of that miracles, Jesus performed quite a bit casting out demons. Quite a bit casting out demons. You know, where did he cast out the first demon? Where? In the synagogue. In the synagogue, isn't it? If anybody needed a miracle, it was the people who were gathered together in Lord's name. They needed the miracle first. And there was demon sitting right there, isn't it? For years and years and years till Jesus came and Jesus casted out that miracle. Isn't it? Praise God. There are many miracles, hallelujah, I believe happens in the church. Praise God. I just want to say that just for the benefit of each one of us, benefit of those who are watching, because we have come from the place that we don't believe in miracles in the church, but if a foreign preacher come, foreign minister come, we go to this meeting and there are miracles there. We come to church on the Sunday, miracles go on vacation. Isn't it? Hallelujah. But I want to tell you, that's not true. That's not true. Miracles are happening in his house. Hallelujah. Praise God. In his church, amongst his people. Hallelujah. Praise God. So book of Acts chapter number 3 verse number 1 says, now Peter and John were going up to temple at the ninth hour, at the hour of prayer. Isn't it? Gujarati also look at you. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Peter and John are going to the temple, isn't it? Now, this is not Jewish Peter and John. These are the Jewish background Peter and John who has received Lord Jesus Christ, who has received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, who are called apostles in that time, and they are going to the temple. And Bible specifically says ninth hour. Gujarati Bible has translated in literal sense from a Hebrew translation saying 3 p.m. in the afternoon, which is very correct. Hallelujah, praise God. Because Jewish day begins at 6. I'm not sure Gujarati day when it begins, but Jewish day begins at 6 o'clock. So 6 o'clock is the first hour, isn't it? Third hour is the 12th o'clock. Sixth hour is 9 o'clock. 12th hour is the 6th o'clock. 6th hour is the 12 o'clock. And 9th hour is 3 p.m. Praise God. Let's open Psalm chapter 55, verse number 17. Kishrasra Panjavan and a Sattara Prakariya. સાંજે બપોરે તથા સવારે હું શોક સહિત વિલાપ કરીશ અંતે મારો સાદ સાંભળશે. ડેવિડ ઇઝ રાઇટિંગ પ્રોફેટિકલી. ટેમ્પલ ઇઝ નોટ બિલ્ટ યેટ, ઇઝન્ટ ઇટ? ટેબનેકલ ઇઝ નોટ ટેબનેકલ ઇઝ ધેટ, બટ ટેમ્પલ ઇઝ નોટ બિલ્ટ યેટ. ધેર વર થ્રી પ્રેયર ટાઈમ્સ ઇન ધ ટેમ્પલ. ઇટ વોઝ ઇન ધ મોર્નિંગ 9 o'clock, આફ્ટરનૂન 12 o'clock, એન્ડ ઇવનિંગ 3 p.m. ઇઝન ઇટ? પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ. થેન્ક યુ જીસસ. સો પીટર એન્ડ જ્હોન are in the temple at the time of 3 p.m. prayer meeting. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. They were there at, my Bible says, they were there at 9th hour. Sada charan hota aya, but 3 vage te hajar hota. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. If you know the life of Daniel, isn't it? Daniel was not in his city, not amongst his people, in a different foreign land. My Bible says, hallelujah, Daniel chapter 6 verse 31, no need to open it, but Daniel opened a window which was facing the city of Jerusalem, and he prayed to God three times a day, which were the prayer times, isn't it? Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. 9 o'clock, 12 o'clock, and 3 o'clock. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. With Jesus, we don't have an ordained prayer time, but we have an ordained day of gathering, which is Sunday. Isn't it? Praise God. God has not given us every day you have to pray exactly at this time. But God has definitely said that on Sunday you are found in the church. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So Peter and John, they are going to the temple. This is the same temple where Jesus preached. For many years, till the Holy Spirit guided them not to go to temple, they would go to temple every day. They'll go to temple every day, especially at prayer time, and they would either preach, or they would minister, or they would heal. And that's what continued to happen. And Luke says in the book of Acts that many miracles happened during this prayer time. And he does not write all of it, but one day, divinely guided by the Holy Spirit, they stopped going to temple. Hallelujah, praise God. We are not going there. Thank you, Jesus. Verse number 2 says, hallelujah, and a man who had been lame from his mother's womb was being carried along, whom they used to set down every day at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, in order to beg alms of those who were entering the temple. Anybody please read it in Gujarati for me. Praise God. This man is lame. Gujarati Bible kaise ke langlo hoto. We don't know what happened. We don't know his medical condition exactly. But he was lame. A Bible tells us it was not an accident ke langlo thai gyo. Kasu thayu etle langlo thai gyo nathi. But he was born like this from his mother's womb. Isn't it? That's what he says. Janmati langlo hoto. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And he's being carried. Thank you, Jesus. Now imagine a plight of this man who has never walked. He does not even know what walking looks like. He has always been carried over from place to place to place by people, isn't it? There was no wheelchairs. There was no TTC wheel transit there. Nothing like that, isn't it? Completely dependent on other people, even to go to a place to beg. Bhik magwani spot par java mate pan, isn't it? 410 na corner par ubha reva mate pan. Somebody has to carry him there. He was completely dependent on individual, because in his own strength, he could not even go into the place where God's presence was there. Praise God. This is also a picture of a sinner like you and me. Isn't it? Praise God. When we were sinners, we were lame like that. Right? Like, we could not even enter the presence of God. Right? And kya baitho tha mandir ni? Bahar baitho tha. It was not in the temple, isn't it? You and I also were outside the temple. Outside the temple of God, we were not in the presence of God until one day Jesus came by in your life and my life. Isn't it? Otherwise, just picture this man as you and me. Hallelujah. Let's open Acts chapter 4, verse number 22. Okay, so now we know something else, because Luke writes it, how old this man is. He's more than 40 plus, isn't it? It's more than 40 years old. He's lame from that. I bet since he got a little bit bigger, he's banging at this temple. And this is day in and day out and hopeless activity, depending on the people to get even food on his table. Utter hopelessness, isn't it? Praise God. And this is city. And Bible also says sitting at a particular place. And the gate of the temple, this is not the city gate, but this is the temple gate. City gates are different, temple gates are different. Temple has 9 gates, city has 12 gates. Hallelujah, praise God. But this particular gate is called a gate beautiful, isn't it? Sundar Nanda Rajo. What an irony. What a counterintuitive perspective. The gate is beautiful and is not. The condition of gate is really beautiful, but the condition of that man is not beautiful at all. Isn't it? Praise God. There is a historian. His name is Josephus. And Josephus writes about this particular gate in history book. It is not written in the Bible. And in history wrote, Josephus says that this gate was majestic gate. It was 75 feet high. If you can imagine, 75 feet is pretty high. Isn't it? Praise God. One floor is around 9 floories. So how you just count, do your math. Isn't it? 8-9 floory high gate. Praise God. It was 60 feet wide, that big a gate. And it needed 20 people to close the gate and open it. 20 logo ne zarur pade close and open the gate. The best part about this gate was, thank you, Jesus. It was overlaid with the thickest plate of gold and Corinthian brass. It was completely covered in gold. Is that? Praise God. See, a lot of times, and I'm not against any religious institution I'm talking about. I'm not talking about not having big church. I pray, believe that God will give us a glorious place as well to sit in. Bigger than this, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. But see, the gate is so beautiful. So much money spent on that gate. So that people, whenever they enter, they look at the gate. Hallelujah, praise God. But while the gate remained beautiful, the condition of people remained deteriorating, isn't it? એ લોકોની પરિસ્થિતિ વધારે વધારે કથળતી ગઈ અને ત્યાં પર પ્રભુનું વચન લુક આગળ લખે છે કે ત્યાં એક આ એકલો જ માણસ હતો ત્યાં ઘણા બધા લોકો ભીખ માંગવા માટે બેસી રહેતા હતા ઇઝન્ટ ઇટ પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ ધ એડમિનિસ્ટ્રેટર ઓફ ધ ટેમ્પલ ટુક કેર ઓફ ધ ગેટ બટ ધે નેવર ટુક કેર ઓફ ધ પીપલ હુ સેટ એટ ધ ગેટ ઇઝન્ટ ઇટ પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ થેન્ક યુ જસ વી ડોન્ટ સી પેન હેન્ડલર્સ હિયર ઓર બેગર્સ હિયર બટ હેવ યુ નોટિસ ધેર આર બેગર્સ આઉટસાઇડ ચર્ચિસ ઇન ઇન્ડિયા ફુગાવડા ઉભા રહે સ્પેશિયલી ક્રિસમસ ટાઈમે There's still baggage there, even though they are out of church. A church has to think about it, isn't it? They're still begging, right? Praise God. It should be different if they're begging at the church. It should make some sort of a difference into their life, because right now they are at the church, isn't it? Praise God. What Jesus would have done, isn't it? Church should have done too. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. And this guy, you know, now apna Bible mathi lakhva maru. He's a very smart guy. And a particular gate che, a gate leads to women's court. Tyanthi વુમન્સ કોર્ટમાં જવાય છે, મહિલાઓ જ્યાં પ્રાર્થના કરવા માટે એ કોર્ટમાં જવાય છે. સો ધીસ ગાય ઇઝ વેરી સ્માર્ટ. હી સેઝ યુ માણસોનું હૃદય થોડુંક, બટ વુમન આર ઇઝીલી, યુ કેન, દે કેન ઇઝીલી મૂવડ બાય કમ્પેશન, દેર ઇઝીલી મૂવડ બાય ધ ઇમોશન્સ એન્ડ લોકેશન લોકેશન લોકેશન. હી ફાઉન્ડ અ પરફેક્ટ લોકેશન ટુ બેગ આઉટસાઇડ વુમન્સ કોર્ટ, ઇઝન્ટ ઇટ? બીકોઝ હી નો દેટ ધીસ ઇઝ વેર ઇઝ ગોના ગેટ ધ મોસ્ટ મર્સી એન્ડ મોસ્ટ પિટી હિયર. હાલેલુયા, પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ, થેન્ક યુ જીસસ, થેન્ક યુ લોર્ડ. એન્ડ બાઇબલ એમ કહે છે કે વોટ વોઝ હી ડુઈંગ ધેર? થેન્ક યુ જીસસ, હી વોઝ બીંગ કેરીડ. અત્યારે ત્યાં બેઠો હતી, પણ પીપલ આર કેરિંગ હિમ સિટ એટ ટેમ્પલ સો દેટ ઇન ઓર્ડર ટુ બેગ. ગુજરાતીમાં શું લખ્યું છે નેહા? ઓકે, સો ગુજરાતી વર્ડ સેઝ ભીખ, ઇઝન્ટ? માય ઇંગ્લિશ બાઇબલ સેઝ વર્ડ આમ, ALMS. ધેર ઇઝ અ ડિફરન્સ બિટવીન ભીખ એન્ડ આમ. સો અધર ટ્રાન્સલેશન ઇઝ ગુડ, બટ ઇઝ નોટ ગુડ. ઇન ધ ઓલ્ડ ટેસ્ટામેન્ટ, ગોડ્સ પીપલ વેર ગિવન અન કમાન્ડમેન્ટ, આઈ એમ સેઇંગ કમાન્ડમેન્ટ, ટુ ડુ થ્રી કાઇન્ડ્સ ઓફ ડોનેશન્સ. સે થ્રી. હાલેલુયા. And I will repeat after me. Tithe, offering, and alms. Isn't it? This is ordained by God. It's not that we just want to do it, but God has ordained this. Jesus is the greatest civil rights activist ever. They took care of the society ever, or the best way that possibly any man can take, can do it. Isn't it? Thank you. Tithe always goes to the temple of the Lord. Tithe belongs to the Lord. When we don't give tithe, we are stealing from Lord, isn't it? So that was one sort of donation that God's people were asked to give. And I praise God. Thank you, Jesus. All who tithe faithfully, there's an amazing blessing when we tithe, isn't it? Praise God. Second blessing is a thanksgiving, isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Not to write name in Kristi Mandu, but just saying, thanksgiving is, hallelujah, you want to give thanks to the Lord, so I'm going to go above and beyond my tithe. Isn't it? God says 10%. No, God, you were so merciful, so faithful. I was not qualified for this job. I got this. I was not qualified to marry this girl. I got married. You know, I'm going to bless the Lord. Thanking, I'm expressing my thank with thanksgiving. And that is called thanksgiving offering. Third offering. Hallelujah. I'm not going to open it because it is written in two places. It is written in the book of Leviticus and book of Deuteronomy. We're not going to go there right now. And third kind of offering, the donation people has to give is called alms. Alms means to bless the poor with the money that you have with. Hallelujah, praise God. See, God took care of poor, isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Book of James says, you know what is the true religion? What is the true religion? True religion is to take care of widows and orphans. God takes care of them, isn't it? Praise God. Bible also says, whoever hurts the most desperate one, he says, you're taking panga with God right now, isn't it? So if anybody mess with orphans, anybody mess with widows, God does not like that, because they are the destitutes of the society, so to say, isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So my Bible says this guy is there and he's gonna beg and he's expecting alm. He also is Jewish person. He also knows, you know, God has said he's gonna give alm. What is a better place to ask for alm? Right outside temple, isn't it? So he's sitting right there. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. When he saw Peter and John about to go into the temple, he began asking to receive the alms. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. It is amazing, if we observe many things in the Bible, we learn a lot of things. Right now it says Peter and John. Now Peter and John are amazing pair. They are not brothers. Are they? No. But they each have a separate set of brother. Peter, Andrew, John has James, isn't it? Praise God. But a lot of places, Peter and John mentioned together. They are perfect ministry partners. Hallelujah. They are good friends. They both walk in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Bible even teaches even afterwards. Hallelujah. When Peter became the leader out of all 12. Hallelujah. Praise God. John, he also has his set of ministry and he's ministered. Says his ministry was the longest. He was the last one to die. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You know, fishing business they had. In that business, Bible says, Peter and Andrew and Joe and John and James, they all were doing the same business in Zebedee Fisheries Company. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. When Passover feast Prabhuye taiyar karwano kidu na, these were the two people who went and prepared the Passover feast. Luke says about it. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus died. Jesus was persecuted. He was put in the tomb. But on the resurrection day, two disciples were at the tomb. Who were they? Peter and John. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God says, you know, I'm gonna take you with me and I'm gonna show you something that you can never see. No tide can do that. No surf can do that. And he shows them the transfiguration of Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, there are three people, but out of them, two are Peter and John. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. While this healing is taking place, there are two disciples right now, Peter and John. Hallelujah. When Philip goes to Samaria and he expounded his ministry there, and there's a lot of people are coming to Lord Jesus Christ, the news comes to Jerusalem. Jerusalem says, oh, wow, the ministry is expanding. Now we're going to get some senior pastor to go there. And they said, we're going to send two people to go to Samaria. And they send Peter and John. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I will tell you, praise God, partnerships are important. Need to have those people in your life that will bring you closer to God. If you didn't hear it, I'm going to say it again. You need to have people in your life that will bring you closer to God. Amen. Praise God. Yeah. Think of with me a man, isn't it? Bible says there was a paralyzed man who was laying in his court, but he has four friends. Four friends didn't care about roof of other people. He said, I don't care even who roof tooti jai, but if Jesus is there, I'm going to get my friend to it no matter what. Have that kind of friends in your life and my life. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. That will tell you, that will correct you, that will encourage you if you are down. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. But one thing and one thing should be common. They will bring you close to God. Hallelujah. Bring you close to God. Hallelujah. So Peter and John, they are here. Thank you, Jesus. And when he's going by, he starts asking. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. But Peter, along with the John, fixed his gaze on him. So there are many, be with me, there are many beggars sitting on the street. Bahut bada bhikhari ho chhe. But ema aa vyakti aa banne paase maangi rahyo chhe. So now Peter looked at him. Let's read verse number 4 for me, please. Amari taraf jo. Gujarati, English mein sohra kyu cha? Look at us. Hallelujah. Peter and John, before he gives him anything, he say, boy, look here. Look at me. Look at me. Praise God. Thank you. And why I think, see, Bible does not write any word without any reason. Prabhu nu vachan kehte ki akash da prithvi jata rahe se pan maru lakhelo ek pan shabd, ek pan kano ke ek pan matra pan jata rahevar nathi. If you were in Ben Hinn's meeting, he was talking about that Hebrew tit and tottle. And he says, it is such a small thing. It is not like small asterisk in top of a word. And he says, even that thing will not go away. Isn't it? Praise God. So this is not reason without reason. I said, Peter, what kind of question is it? Look at us, right? Like, what is it? Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. It is important to look in a direction where you are going. I give you a practical example, right? If you're going in a particular direction, in whatever direction you look, you will go in that direction. Okay, let me explain it again. Praise God. If you're driving, let's say if you're driving, right? You're driving and driving straight. Bhai mein Lamborghini pasar tha hai, isn't it? You start looking at it, right? What will happen? Your car will start going there. Be stay away. Oh, insurance is too expensive. If you hit a Lamborghini, oh boy, we need to pray for that, isn't it? Wherever you look, that's where you keep going. I attended a special school. They stopped the school. It's called a skid control school. So they were teaching, especially I drive a lot for my work. So they were teaching what happens in snow, how you drive. And they simulated this nice parking lot. And they gave us a car with tire, na koi pan threads nahi, completely bald tires. And they would simulate skidding, okay, what would happen in ice condition. And what do you do in that condition? Isn't it? So I was there almost a whole day training. A lot of people throw time on the chakra mara because guy is going in all directions. And they teach you how to control the car. He says, while you're going in this direction and car gets skid, what you do, you keep looking in the direction that you're supposed to go. Your hand will follow. Your hand will start moving the steering. It's called a muscle memory in a direction that you're looking. And ultimately, you'll be able to gain control of the car. So where you are looking is very important, because that's where you will go. I'm not listening, everybody. Where you're looking is very important, because that's where you will go, isn't it? Praise God. Don't look left or right. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. Where was Peter looking? Peter was looking at the storm. Where did he go? He went into the storm. Till the time he was looking at Jesus, he was walking on the water. The moment he took his gaze away from Jesus and he started looking at the storm around him, he was drowning. Isn't it? A lot of times he's saying, Lord, I'm drowning in the conditions. Boy, you're looking at the wrong place. Look at me, Jesus says. Isn't it? When we look at him, hallelujah, the storm may arise, but we will not drown. Amen. I've got, Jesus won't promise there's no storm. Hallelujah. But Jesus would promise, if you keep looking at Jesus, you will not drown. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. So Peter says to this guy, particular guy, he said, look at me. And ultimately, he's pointing this guy to look at Jesus, isn't it? Praise God. Thank you. Leonardo da Vinci, we all know that guy, isn't it? Crazy guy who could do outrageous paintings and all those things. That movie came, that was nonsense. It's a hypothetical story, so it's not. There's nothing true about that story, isn't it? But Leonardo da Vinci painted very famous paintings, few of them very famous. And one of the most famous paintings is Last Supper. Mara ghar bhi hai, but it painted by Leonardo da Vinci nahi. But that's the one. It's painted by Leonardo da Vinci, isn't it? And that painting is still right now in a convent in a city of Milan, Italy. Painting right now. So after he painted the painting, he called up a friend who was a good critic as well. And he showed him this painting. So the guy looked at the painting, took some time, and he said, out of the whole painting, the most amazing thing is highlighting is the cup, which is silver, sitting on the table. So Leonardo da Vinci took a brush and right away rubbed the cup dull. And this is what he says. He said, comma into inverted comma. He says, I meant that the figure of Christ should be first and mainly attract the observer's eyes. Whatever diverts the attention from him must be blotted out. The attention should be not the cup. Attention should be not be table. Attention should not be bread. Attention should not be wine. It should be Master Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. John the Baptist said that, isn't it? Hallelujah. We sing it, but it's not easy. Isn't it? It's not easy to say, okay, Lord, I decrease, you increase. It's not easy, because there will be a time, there will be a battle come in your life and my life where you will fight against God. You will fight against the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. At that time, hallelujah, you have to put yourself down. You take the insults. Take the injury, take the loss. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. So that chiglaschan and a fade kar de amave, and Master Jesus would shine out of your life and my life. Amen. Hallelujah, praise God. I shared a testimony and I was moved. I was crying listening to the testimony. There was an incident happened in the United States. In that incident, a police officer shot this black guy, 14-year-old guy. Whatever reasons, there's a lot of racism going on in the United States. I'm not going there. And this court case is happening, and in actual court, it's not a hypothetical story, it is very recent story, isn't it? This guy whose brother is killed by this particular police officer, white lady officer, he's sitting right there, she's been given a jail time and all those things, and he sits in a witness box and says, I want to tell you something. And he says, my brother is not there, but even if he's there, he would want you to know Jesus. And he says, you may serve jail. And it's not that what I want. But he says, I forgive you in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. The guy hugged the killer of his own brother. And said, may you find Jesus while you serve your time. That is what drawing your attention to Jesus. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So while Peter is attracting his attention, he's diverting that attention ultimately to the strength, power, and the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Verse number 5. Mm-hmm. English must do like you.
The man gave his attention, expecting to get something from them.
Praise God. So be with me. This guy sitting there is shouting, alms, alms. Everybody is shouting, it's alms, alms. And while John comes, Peter, look at me. And this guy, look at them. Hallelujah, praise God. And he's expecting that Peter's going to give him something. Be with me. Peter and John are the pillar of the church. Bible writes about it, isn't it? Ke logo manirya suje stambh che. Bible lakhe che. Special lakhe che. They are the beginning of the church. So whatever they did was actual ministry of the church as well, isn't it? Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you. Jare aaj apne wishes talk about that people money at the feet of apostles that was used to give out to poor as well, isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. That is church's jobs, church's ministries, church's calling to serve people and give money, help to poor and destitute. This is biblical, 100% biblical. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. But, hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. Thomas Aquinas, if you have heard the name of it, it was an old monk and he's visiting a pope in a Vatican around 12th century. 12th century na Pope ne visit kare jo Vatican ni andar, and a Pope brings him to a treasury, and he says to Aquinas, Pope says, we can't say silver and gold I have none because we have it. Aquinas gave a very poignant answer. He says, you see Thomas, the church no longer can say silver and gold, I have none. So Thomas says, I do see that, but I see something further. If church cannot see that, say that I have silver and gold, I have none, church also cannot say that, rise up and walk anymore. It can't say anymore, rise up and walk. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. This guy is looking at Peter and John that he will get something. He's expecting. He's expecting to receive something. And a lot of time we miss that part of it. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. When we come into the presence of God, are we expecting? Not from me, not from church, and not from anybody, but are we expecting from God? Hallelujah, praise God. It is called the spirit of expectancy, isn't it? Hallelujah, praise God. When I'm praying with an expectation to receive it. Isn't it? Then I'm praying without faith. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. And it is very important, hallelujah, to have that spirit of expectancies. Hallelujah. Praise God. I've seen a lot of time we go so casually to the meeting, so casually to the church, so casually to everywhere else. But we are not expecting things to change. Hallelujah. Praise God. But when we come with prayer, when we come with fasting, when we come with a lot of thanksgiving to the presence of God, I'm expecting. I'm expecting God to move. I'm expecting the Holy Spirit to show up. I'm expecting the greater manifestation of the Word of God. I'm expecting the greater anointing of the Word of God. I'm expecting the signs and wonders and miracles should take place. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. As this guy is expecting, I want to encourage you and me, church. Hallelujah. Praise God. Whenever we are praying, whenever we are found sitting in the presence of God, come with an expectant heart. Hallelujah. Come with the spirit of expectancy. Not just listening to the same thing, going and forget about it. Hallelujah. Praise God. But God, I'm going to make a deal, God. I'm going to come there. I'm going to spend my 3 hours there. I'm not going to go back empty-handed today. I'm going to receive it, whatever you have in store for me today. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. And the best part is, you and I don't have to do anything about it. Jesus has done everything what he has done. Hallelujah. Verse number 6. And that's where the focus of my message is. But Peter said to him, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. I do not have silver or gold. Or silver and gold, I have none. But what I do have, I give it to you. I'm not going to give you, boy, what I don't have. But I have something better than silver and better than gold. Hallelujah. And whatever I have, I give it to you. And he speaks, in the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. You and I do not qualify anything from God. Hallelujah. Praise God. But if we are desperate enough, if we are destitute enough, we will receive from God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's say if you're living in the house, you don't qualify for fire department. But if your house is in fire, you qualify for fire department, isn't it? The same way, hallelujah, if life is a mess, you qualify for the grace, isn't it? Hallelujah, praise God, because that's how it works. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Peter says something amazing. And why I put this in out-of-the-box miracle? Because you don't encounter anything like that before, isn't it? This is the first miracle performed by apostles. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. Bible summarizes Jesus' ministry a few times. Matthew chapter 4, verse 25. Let's open that. 23. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Matthew 4, 23. Quickly. Isn't it? This is what Jesus did. Hallelujah. Praise God. Jesus has preached in the synagogue. He proclaimed the gospel. He healed every disease and he and every sickness. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Matthew 9, 20, 35 says the same thing. Mark 1, 39 says the same thing. Again and again and again. It's been keeping repeated. That's what Jesus did. Preach the gospel, heal the sick, cast out the demons. Preach the gospel, heal the sick, cast out the demons. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And this is what Jesus did. And this is what Jesus continues to do. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. He heals the diseases and he casts out demons. But this time it's different now. This time Jesus is not there, but they are his people there. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's open one verse. 2 Corinthians 13, verse number 5. Isu Christ kona ma chhe? Tamara ma chhe, isn't it? Praise God. Jesus is not present there when Peter and John walked in. But my Bible teaches us Jesus is present in Peter and John. And that is what brought out this miracle. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, you and I are the carriers of Lord Jesus Christ. You and I are the vessels of Lord Jesus Christ. When we walk, Jesus does not walk with us. He walks within us as well. Hallelujah. Because Bible says not one time. Colossians 1 verse number 27 says, Christ in you is the hope of glory. Hallelujah. Christ in you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Then Romans 8 says, Christ lives within you. Hallelujah. Praise God. When he is living within you and within me, it means he's working through you and working through me. Hallelujah. What I'm trying to tell today right now, praise God. Yes, we're going to pray to God to do the miracles into your life. Hallelujah. But, hallelujah, you and I become the instrument of that miracle in people's life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Colossians. Thank you, Jesus. Let's wait there before we go there. Wait. I'm going to go there. Give me 1 minute. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus is in you and Jesus is in me. And Jesus continues to do what he continues to do. He still preaches. He still casts out demons. He still sick. He still heals sick people. Hallelujah. But then you and I have to walk along with the presence of Most High God. Bible teaches us that he is within me. Hallelujah. Praise God. Whenever there is need of a prayer, be bold to pray for that, because Jesus within you would do that as well. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm not criticizing anybody, but there are a few ground rules that we establish. And then what are the ground rules means? You can't debate it over and over and over again. We establish it's there, it's true. We put it on the shelf and we believe and we walk by it. One thing is laying of hands. And I'm not condemning anybody, but I'm just trying to encourage you. If you're far, stretch your hand. If you're here, if you're close by, don't stretch your hands. I'm not going to pray like this. I'm going to pray like this, yes. Right? Because Bible teaches us, lay your hands over him. We need to be confident of Lord Jesus Christ within you. And that's what he would have wanted us to do. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. It is not us. It is never us who does the miracle. It is the Christ Jesus within us who does this miracle. Hallelujah. I want to encourage all the parents right now. Lay hands on your children and pray. Lay hands every day and pray. I don't care how big they are. Isn't it? If they are still under your umbrella, lay hands and pray over them. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Because when you lay hands, hallelujah, you're exercising the authority of the name of Jesus that is within you. Colossians chapter 3:17. Let's go there now. Okay, let's stop right there. Kona name karo? So now something comes into our highlight. It's the name of Jesus, isn't it? Peter says, silver and gold, I have none. Mai paase sonu ke roop nahi, but I have something else. And what I'm going to give it to you is the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, praise God. That is the most powerful thing. Hallelujah, praise God. Is the name of Jesus. Colossians says, whatever you do in deed or act, do it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, praise God. John 14:14 says, whatever you shall ask in my name, it shall be done to you. John 16:23 says, whatever you shall ask the Father in my name, it shall be done unto you. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. When Peter and John says that, whatever I have, give it to you. In the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. Hallelujah. A lot of people were amazed at this miracle. Let's go Acts chapter 4. They're still discussing miracle after one chapter. Isn't it? Acts 4:13. Farasinu kaam hai, isn't it? Discussion. Mm-hmm. Isn't it? Peter and John abhan agnata. But even though you are abhan and even though you are agnan, but if you have name of Jesus, you can do this miracle in the name of Jesus. You don't need your qualification. You did not need your expertise. It does not need your degree at all. The only qualification criteria that is needed to get this miracle done in your life and my life is the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. You know, a Pharisee understand that. Modern-day Pharisees don't get it. They're still debating miracles happen or not. Those Pharisees understood it. Isn't it? Praise God. They understood that miracle has happened. And they can't deny that miracle right now. So you know what they said to them? Let's Acts chapter 4. Let's read verse number 18. Isn't it? So this is what they said. They didn't say don't do miracle. They didn't say don't healing. But they said, don't do two things. He said, don't preach and don't speak the name of Jesus. Because if the name of Jesus is not there, miracles not going to happen. Isn't it? Even they understood that. They said, we cannot deny this miracle. Prabhu nu vachan em ke che, logo ke che, ke aa miracle badhana dekhta apni same thayo che. And aa miracle ne apne deny kari shakye em nathi. So what they do, they go and rebuke them and say, don't speak the name of Jesus. Because they even understood that there's a power that lies, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. It's in the name, man. It is in the name. And that is the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, praise God. Shakespeare asked that question, isn't it? What's in the name? But that's a rhetorical question. Shakespeare didn't know what Jesus Christ says. That is, there's a name, highest name. And that is the name of Jesus. What name does? What name does? Whatever you shall ask in my name, my Father will listen to you. If you want to be heard by God, it is the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. See, in the book of Acts, they did not have a program. They did not have healing ministry or healing crusade. I'm not against it. I fully agree with that. Okay? Praise God. The only thing they have, wherever they go, boy, what's the plan for healing? Okay, I got something. What do you got? The name of Jesus. And that's enough to perform miracles. That's enough to heal this diseases. It's enough to cast out every demon on the face of this earth. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Prabhu, we need to understand. Lord, we read it, but we miss that part. He says, Bible says, when two or three are gathered together, where? In my name. It's in the name. In my name. Bible says, I shall be there. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. Are getting baptized with the waters of baptisms. Hallelujah. My Bible says, Matthew chapter 8, 28, verse number 19. He says, preach gospel to all the corners of the earth, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. It is in the name. It is in the name. Name carries the authority. Name carries the access. Name carries the power. Name carries, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, the requirement, what needs to be fulfilled. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. Even Peter, when he preached the first sermon on the day of Pentecost, Acts chapter 2, verse 28, he says, repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Not according to Jesus, not according to what Jesus did, but it is in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's open a Philippians chapter 2, verse number 8. Hallelujah. I'm going to read. You're going to follow with me. Praise God. Thank you. And being found, Philippians 2, 8. And being found in the appearance of a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even to the death of cross. Therefore, everybody say therefore. God has highly exalted him. Hallelujah. Praise God. He says, given him the name that is above every name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. If you have some other translation, he says, given him the name that is highest name. Hallelujah. There is no other name higher than the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. The name of Jesus is higher than every sickness and every disease. Hallelujah. Praise God. The name of Jesus is higher than every lack and every poverty. Hallelujah. The name of Jesus is higher than every situation that you and I could ever face. The name of Jesus is higher than every circumstances, every enemy, every opposition, every demons, every false god, every anxiety, every depression. Hallelujah. Because my Bible says his name is the name above every other name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. This is a blessing is in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. That's why verse number 10 says, at his name, what will happen? Every knee. Everybody say every knee. Every knee shall bow. Hallelujah. Praise God. When it says every knee, it means every knee. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. Where? In heaven, on earth, and under the earth. Hallelujah. There's a lot of bowing down going to happen under the earth as well at the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Book of Acts is all about one name and one name alone. It is the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let me explain this name of Jesus thing one more time. Hallelujah. Praise God. You know where I work. Everybody knows where I work. I work for CFI and I have to visit a lot of third party individuals and I have to introduce myself because they don't know me. I'm not there every day. I don't work for them, but I work for government. So when I walk into the office, I usually carry two things with me. I would have my identity card and I would have my badge, which is given to me by Government of Canada. Isn't it? So I would show it to them. And he says, I'm here because I am from? I am nobody. What I'm doing right now, I'm representing. I'm not the government of Canada. I'm not even related to Prime Minister. Isn't it? Isn't it? But I'm coming in the name of the government of Canada. When I show that card, you know what they do? Please come in. They let me come in. They let me inspect the plant. They give me the office to sit in. Isn't it? Praise God. You know why? Because I'm carrying the authority of the name of Government of Canada. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let me tell you guys, you and I are carrying that authority. Hallelujah. Praise God. I am here nothing. Praise God for that. But I am here. I am a representative of my Lord and Savior, Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Each one of us are. Hallelujah. Praise God. We are representative of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Wherever you go, hallelujah, you represent Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. When I have that card, it means Government of Canada has given me that authority. When you carry the card of Jesus, you carry the authority of Lord Jesus Christ. You can say those. Boy, I got the authority from my daddy. He has given me that authority because he has given me the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Let's open quickly Matthew chapter 10, verse 1. Be with me. We are there. Hallelujah. The name of Jesus and authority. The name of Jesus and authority. Matthew 10, 1. So So Jesus gave them authority. You can cast out demons. You can heal every sicknesses and blah, blah, blah. All those things Jesus gave authority over. And we know what happens. Huh? And this is mentioned in all four Gospels, in Luke as well. So when he has given once to 12 disciples, once to 70. And when 70 comes back, you see, 70 comes back after their ministry trip because Jesus gave them authority. They go and they cast out demons everywhere. They heal everywhere. Isn't it? And when they come back, hallelujah, praise God. I'm just one more question before I move forward. Jesus could go anywhere he wanted. He could time travel. He is faster than flesh. He could do anything, whatever he wanted. But why he sent those people having that authority? He's doing the same thing right now. He wants to send people in his authority. Amen. So that we can reach out the end of the earth. Amen. Hallelujah. So when those 70 comes back, let's read that verse specifically. Luke 10, verse number 17. Luke 10, 17. Luke 10, 70. Sorry. Prabhu Tara. The demons were subject to us because in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Peter says, silver and gold, I have none. I have only one thing. And that name is the highest name on the earth. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. But it's important when you carry that name, you also have Jesus within you. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. A lot of time people falsify police no uniform, isn't it? But they are not police. They may work once or twice, but they can get caught. You can use the name of Jesus, but without authority given by Jesus, it's not going to last. Jesus is not just the key that you can use without having him rule in your life. I want to make that very clear. Very clear. It's not the name of Jesus, the name of Jesus, forget who is Jesus. That's not how it's going to work. You need to have that Jesus inside and then you get that authority. Hallelujah. Praise God. Be with me. I want to bring you some Luke chapter 19. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Luke 19, verse number 11. Somebody start reading for me. Verse 11. Yes. Acts 19. Look at Lucky, but still. That's what I meant. Looks at the book. 11. Okay. So be right there. So, through Paul, I can give you English version of Bua is exorcist. Isn't it? I never knew this word is in the Bible, man. Bua. I know Bua. I've seen Buas. They're crazy guys. Anyways, we had a neighbor who was Bua. Anyway. Anyways. Okay, let's come back here. I'm getting distracted. Isn't it? So, amazing miracles happening through Paul's life, handkerchiefs, aprons, people are touching, people are getting healed. So people figured out, you know, this is something happening with the name of Jesus. So they don't even know Jesus. They are still exorcists. They are casting out demons. We're going to start doing the same thing. All you just need the name of Jesus. We're going to cast out demons in the name of Jesus. That's what they started doing. Verse number 14. Isn't it? Pastor na chokra bhi karta tha. PKs. High priest na saat chokra cha, isn't it? Pastor kids. Isn't it? High priest na saat chokra. We don't know. They are still Yahudi. We're going to cast out demons in the name of Jesus. Isn't it? They are exercising that authority without having Jesus in their heart. This is what happens. Verse number 13. Be with me. I'm going to read that. An evil spirit answered to them. Evil spirit said to them. He says, Jesus? No. I know Jesus. Paul. I know Paul. Because Paul has Jesus inside him. That's why I know Paul as well. I know the name of Jesus. I know the name of Paul. But then he has a question. But who are you? Even though you're speaking name of Jesus, there is no Jesus within you. There is no Jesus inside you. There is no presence of Jesus within you. Hallelujah. And my Bible says what happened. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Verse number, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Verse number 16. Then in the man whom the evil spirit was leaped them, overpowered them, prevailed against them, so they fled out of that house naked and wounded. Isn't it? They use the name of Jesus without authority. Hallelujah. Praise God. So Jesus is not just the key that anybody can use. You need to have Jesus sitting on your heart. Then you can use that key to open the doors. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. The name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. If you don't even know what to pray in certain situations, sometimes, you know, you encounter that situation, Lord, I don't know what to pray. I know what. I tell you what to pray. Speak unto the name of Jesus. Invoke the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Because that name, the highest name on earth, in heaven, under the earth. The name of Jesus. Everything happens in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Proverbs chapter 18, verse number 10. No need to open it, but this is my favorite verse. The name of the Lord is a
strong tower.
If you're scared, go into the name of Jesus. Because he's a tower that protects you. If you're feeling anxious, go into the strong tower. If you're feeling depressed, go into the strong tower. If you're discouraged, go into the strong tower. Because that protects you and protects me. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I saw a video of actual video footage, which was recorded into this particular store. And this store owner was a lady. And I believe this is somewhere in the southern belt. And this in a store, this guy with the masked face walked in with a gun on his hand, and he's trying to rob this lady. And the actual footage shows, and this is not a video that is made by, this is not a dramatization, but actual footage shows, the woman says, "I rebuke you in the name of Jesus." And the guy fled. Because that is the highest name in earth, on heaven, under the earth. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Peter says, arise and walk. Let's read one more verse. Mark chapter 16, verse number 17. I'm going to read this special verse because a lot of time people believe that kya abda kaam khali apostle na maate rakhela tha. Apne kasu? Isn't it? 16, verse number 17. It's not just for apostle. Let's read Mark 16, verse number 17. Okay, this signs is for those who? It's not that they have title called apostles, isn't it? They were great men, I'm not denying that. But this sign is for those who believe in my name. What will do?
In my name, they will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues.
Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. You don't have to be apostle. You don't have to be prophet. Hallelujah, praise God. But if you have the name of Jesus, you can cast out demons. If you have the name of Jesus, you can exercise the authority that is given by Jesus to you to perform signs and wonders and miracles. We can pray over sick with the expectation they will get healed. Hallelujah. We will lay hands over people who are demon possessed, and we pray and believe that they will be released, because we have the highest name, and on that name, every knee shall bow and every tongue will confess. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Peter does not stop there. Peter is just saying, hey, man, I have something. Rise up and walk. Verse number 7. Let's read that. And this is what makes this miracle out of the box. Hallelujah. Praise God. You see, Peter, those two, both of them, mari baat samjhi na. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to exercise that faith. Isn't it? It's not just your faith, but it's my faith as well. I'm going to exercise over you. Hallelujah. Praise God. A lot of time, if you read Bible carefully, a lot of time it is the faith of people who brought the sick person to Jesus make them receive their healing. Amen. Peter said, boy, you don't have enough faith. 40 verse to better jo used to take your. I know this is what happens. Isn't it? You get used to it. What Yesu mangi rahe ho, bhik mangi rahe ho. Peter ki bhik. I'm going to give you something amazing. He said, I'm not going to give you a token. I'm not going to deny you or something like that. I have name of Jesus. He says, rise up and walk. The guy still doesn't rise up and walk. Bible says, Peter grabbed his right hand. Pulled him up. Get up. What did he do? What happens? Chorayu. Anetimana. Hallelujah, praise God. Chalwa lagyo. Hallelujah, praise God. Hallelujah, praise God. He says, I'm not going to sit outside the temple anymore. I'm going to go inside. Isn't it? Praise God. But that required Peter to grab him up and pull him out. A lot of times, sometimes we lack that. Let me tell you, my Father is so gracious. My Father is so gracious that even when we lack it, even if we don't get up, sometimes he stoops down and helps us to get up as well. Isn't it? Praise God. Hallelujah. He has grabbed us all out of the mess and make us a miracle. Isn't it? He has grabbed us out of bondage and has made us free. He has grabbed us out of darkness and brought us into the light. He has grabbed us out of death and brought us into the new life. Hallelujah. Praise God. If you are still sitting in the mess, I want to tell you, God has extended his arm for you and me in the name of Jesus. Grab that arm and come out. Hallelujah. Rise up and walk in the name of Jesus. Don't keep sitting at the place of the mess. Don't keep sitting at the place of complacency, backsliding. Hallelujah. Praise God. The greatest problem that Christian faces onto this earth, and I get a lot of questions being asked, what if I backslide? Hallelujah. Praise God. Grab the hand of Jesus. Rise up and walk. Don't keep sitting backslid. Isn't it? You can always move ahead when you hold on to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Peter did not just say, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And it is amazing. Hallelujah. Praise God. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse number 9. It's not Peter. I'm saying, okay, you are holy nation. And you are, tame krishni pavitra praja, tata rajmanya, yajak varcho. Tell your neighbor, I'm the high priest. Even though we may not do it like it, Bible says we are the royal priesthood. Isn't it? We are the royal priesthood. You know, the priest know Latin words, pontifex. Isn't it? Pontifex. You know what is the meaning of pontifex? Bridge builder. Bridge? Isn't it? Jesus, Peter is going to write, you are the high priest. Peter say, boss, I am the high priest. If you're not going to come to Jesus, I am going to become a bridge between you and God. I am going to grab your hand. I am going to pull you up. And I am going to bring you to God. Hallelujah. Lot of time what we lack is we preach, we teach, we hit people with the head on, Bible on their head, but we don't become a bridge builder. God wants you and me to be bridge builder. Grab people out of their mess. Bring them to Jesus. That's what God wants us to be. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Peter brought him out. Hallelujah. And it is very important for us to know that. C.T. Studd says, and I love this quote so much so. He says, hallelujah. I don't want to. He says, some like to live in the sounds of the church or the chapel bells, City Start said. But I want to build a rescue mission within a yard of hell. Isn't it? Praise God. We want to save people out. We want to bring people to Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I want to encourage you. Praise God. Hallelujah night is happening. It just happened once a year. Hallelujah. But we have flea market right here. I know we are busy. I'm not pointing finger. I'm not bringing any guilt, shame, condemnation. Hallelujah. Praise God. We are bridge builders. We have to ask ourselves, have we built any bridge? Have we brought a name of Jesus to somebody? Have we spoke and commanded somebody to rise up and walk in the name of Jesus? We can't even complain about lack of opportunities. We have ample. If you don't know, I can give you some. There's ample opportunities. Serve Jesus. Hallelujah. 2020, God is burdening me, us, to prepare ourselves for the second coming of Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Isn't it? Praise God. One question will be asked. What did you do with what I gave it to you? I can't say, well, throw busy thinking of those. It's not going to work there. Isn't it? Praise God. Be a bridge builder. Be a change maker. Life will continue. Life would have challenges. Life would have problems. Even if you don't minister, the challenge is going to continue. But if you serve and if you minister, if you become a bridge builder, you would have a different perspective to life's problem. Isn't it? It won't sound that big to you. Serve where God has called you to serve. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. I'm going to close right now. Thank you. He stood up. He walked. He jumped. Started praising God. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It is the name of Jesus. It is the name of Jesus. Bill Winston says this is like this. When we call unto the name of Jesus, the anointing is released. And it conquers and eradicates every works and assignment of the Satan. When you invoke the name of Jesus, isn't it? Hallelujah, praise God. It is such a powerful tool that God has given you and me. We don't take it seriously, isn't it? Praise God. So I want to challenge you, encourage you, praise God, hallelujah. Use that name, use that authority that is given to you and given to me. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, praise God. My father-in-law worked as a lawyer, isn't it? And you all have dealt with legal matters back home, right? Especially when you're in your area, there's somebody who is taking care of your business back home. You give them something called power of attorney. Hallelujah. Praise God. Power of attorney means you're given your power to them to act on your behalf. Isn't it? That's what it means. Right? Right. Auntie's there as well. She worked in court. Right? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. It means somebody's going to act on your behalf, even though they are not you. Isn't it? So if you give a power of attorney to somebody, they can sign on your behalf. They can sell on your behalf. They can buy on your behalf. They can spend your money on your behalf. They can behave and do everything that you could do, but on your behalf. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus has signed a power of attorney. Hallelujah. Praise God. And he has assigned you and me as attorneys. Jesus said, I give my authority to you. I am assigning you as my attorneys. Hallelujah, praise God. And I am giving you power. How much power? All the power. Hallelujah, praise God. The book of John says, not double portion anointing, but the Spirit without measure. I give it to you. I give it to you. I give it to you. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. Now, once we have received the power of attorney, you and I can act on behalf of Lord Jesus Christ. If Jesus is passing by, if somebody is sick, he would not pass by without praying for them or healing for them. Isn't it? Hallelujah, praise God. If we see, hallelujah, Bible, he cried 3 times in the Bible, isn't it? That's what it says, 3 different occasions. One, and they are all very important occasions. Once he died outside Lazarus' tomb, not because of his friend, but it is because he see what a sin can do. Sin can lead to death. Jesus Christ, that's not what my plan was. Isn't it? Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. You and I should be crying at the death of people. Not just physical death, but spiritual death. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus cried outside the city of Jerusalem. Why did he cry? He says, how many times I wanted to gather them. They're not listening to my voice. Hallelujah. We should be crying and praying for people. Those are still not in God's sheepfold. Because that is the heart of Jesus. Hallelujah, praise God. But you will not able to do it yourself. Jesus has signed a power of attorney. And Jesus has given you seal. And that seal is his name. Wherever you go, you carry the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Because on the name of Lord Jesus Christ, every work is done. Every sickness is healed. Every demon is cast out. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I want to encourage you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. As I close, let's stand up. Let's stand up. Let's stand up. I want to encourage you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. We will walk in the authority authority of the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, name of Jesus. Amen. Tell your neighbor, I have the authority of the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We will walk in the authority of the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We will become victorious over the schemes of enemy in the name of Jesus. We will walk with the boldness in the name of Jesus. We will overcome every fear, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Every sin that is entangling us or trapping us, we will be able to become victorious over it in the name of Jesus. Every anxiety, every worry, darek jatni chinta, we will overcome that in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, praise God. Every depression to go in the name of every lack, hallelujah, to be provided in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Because the name of Jesus, hallelujah, the name of Jesus, my Bible says that is the highest name given by God in heaven, on earth and under the earth. Hallelujah. Praise God. My Bible also says, hallelujah, praise God, in the name of Jesus, everyone who is called unto the name of Jesus shall be saved, will receive the salvation, will receive the healing, will receive the miracles, hallelujah, as promised by God. Hallelujah. All your blessing waits, awaits in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. Let's shout out once again, Jesus. Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We want to praise you. We want to worship you. We want to exalt you because you have given us the most powerful thing, and that is the name of Jesus, Lord. Hallelujah. You have given us, hallelujah, the authority to walk in that name. You have given us authority, hallelujah, to pray over the sickness in the name. We have given us authority to cast demons in that name. Hallelujah, Lord. Help us to walk in that authority, Father God. Lord, I pray for my people right now. I pray for my church right now, Lord. Hallelujah. The name of Jesus will be their strength, oh my Lord. The name of Jesus will be their provisions right now. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Wherever there is lack, hallelujah. Wherever there are needs, all the needs be met and fulfilled in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Wherever there are sicknesses, aches and pains in the bodies, Father God, hallelujah, be healed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you. Wherever there is self-doubt, oh my Lord, hallelujah. The confidence comes into the life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, I pray, oh my Lord, hallelujah, for the loved ones who has not come to you yet, Lord. I pray every power of darkness, every close dies, hallelujah, every chains be broken down in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Every addiction flee in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. I pray, oh my Lord, hallelujah, every hard heart be melted down in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Every prayer be answered, yes and amen, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. When we walk out of this place, Father God, help us to walk in that victory, Father God. Help us to walk in that confidence, Father God. Hallelujah, Lord. I pray in Jesus' name, Father God. We once again bow down to you, Father God. As Peter said, as John said, hallelujah. We also proclaim, Lord, we are nothing without your name, Father God. Let your name be continue to be lifted out high into our heart, into our mind, into our life, into our being, into our families, into our houses, into our church, Father God, is my prayer. Lord, I ask health and healing, provision, peace, prosperity for all these people, Father God. As we walk out, help us to walk in the peace and joy that is in Christ Jesus. Lord, I pray once again, let your kingdom come and let your will be done in and among us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. O Akash Manavanava, Naam Pavitramana, Tamavu Rajya, Chema Akashma, તેમ પૃથ્વી પર તમારી ઈચ્છા પૂરી થા દિવસને મારી રોટલી આજ અમને આપો જેમ અમારું માફ કર્યા છે તેમ તમે મારું માફ કરો અમને પરીક્ષામાં ના લાવ અને મારો છુટકો કરો કેમ કે રાજ્ય પરાક્રમ તથા મહિમા સર્વકાળ સુધી તમારા છે Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Our Dev Bapno Jaib Jeo Prem, Prabhu Isu Krishna Krupa, and Pavitra Atmani Sangat, Apan Sarvani Sate, Hamnati Sada Sarvakar Sudhu. Amen.